Attempted to do this. First couple of times you couldn't hear me, so we're gonna try it this way. I was gonna use a projector, but it definitely didn't work, so I'm just gonna have to go old school and use the dry erase board. Okay. So, anyway, I just wanted to clarify a few things. When you were doing your daily grades, I noticed some of you were getting confused, especially on the pictures, so I just want to make sure that everybody's understanding. Okay, so I'll start with mitosis. That's what we were studying before we went on spring break and before everything wacko. Okay, so here we go. Remember, mitosis, you start with prophase. Okay, so you're going to see the nuclear material break down. You're going to see chromosomes appear, centrioles move to the opposite end, and spindle fibers form. Okay, so that's prophase. Then that moves into mama metaphase. Remember, mama meta, mama middle. So spindle fibers completely form, chromosomes in the center of the cell, okay? Then moves into the away phase, anaphase, the away phase. That's when you see the spindle fibers start to get shorter. You see chromatids pulling away from each other, okay? So it's the away phase. And then, of course, that goes into telophase, where you start to see two separate cells forming. You'll see the nuclear material reappear. Remember, it disappeared in prophase, reappears in telophase. And those chromatids become chromatin, becomes a stringy chromatin. All right, so, and then of course, those are going to split, cytokinesis, division of cytoplasm. It's going to split, and you're going to end up with two cells. All right, mitosis. That's what this is. Now, it's important for, I know you all know, if you were here, you would tell me, it's important for growth and repair. Okay, so this is how you went from that one single cell, that zygote, into trillions of cells, right? That's what you are now. All right, so growth and repair, chromosome number stays the same. All right, so what that means is this cell had 46 chromosomes, okay? That's the diploid number. These two cells are gonna have 46 apiece, okay? They're going to be diploid. So it goes diploid to diploid. Okay, chromosome number does not change. All right, so that's mitosis. We all knew that. You're like, yeah, that's a review. Okay, so now meiosis. Okay, and this is where some of you were like getting a little bit confused. So let's make sure we're all on the same page. All right, so meiosis has two divisions, okay? So it has two rounds of PMAT. And so you're gonna start with prophase one. You're gonna see nuclear material disappear, centrioles move, spindle fibers form, same old thing, right? Okay, but you're going to see the chromosomes are going to pair up with each other. You're gonna see, they're called homologous, H-O-M-O, homo, same. So homologous chromosomes pair up. You have 23 chromosomes from your mom, 23 from your dad. So they have pairs, they match up. They have a partner that they match up with. All right, so that's what's happening there. So those chromosomes are pairing up. We call that synapsis. It's the process of them getting close together. I say they synap together, okay? And when they're like that, they're like two old ladies exchanging information with each other. You know how old ladies are when they get together and they gossip, right? So they're exchanging information. All right, so that's called crossing over. Very important, because crossing over is what makes you different from me. It makes you different from your parents. It makes you different from everybody else. Okay, so crossing over is what makes us genetically unique. All right, so it goes prophase, and then it's going to go into metaphase one. So this is prophase one. Then it goes to metaphase one. So we see centrioles, spindle fibers form. Okay, but this time you're going to see them in the middle, but they're going to be lined up in pairs. Okay, so you're going to see those pairs of chromosomes. And when they're paired up, you remember crossing over has already occurred. So you would see some genetic variation in these chromosomes. You would see where they had exchanged DNA with each other. So that's what I'm doing, the different colors. It's just showing that they swapped some parts of the chromosome with each other. Okay? So that's mama metaphase. They're in the middle. All right, then anaphase. That's the away phase, right? So we see the spindle fibers shorten. Okay? And then we see those chromosomes pull away from each other. Now notice, there's not chromatids pulling away. It's the buddies, right? Where they had buddied up, or they had partnered up. They're pulling away from each other. All right, and then you have telophase one. So this is metaphase one. This is anaphase one. Okay, and then you go into telophase one. All right, so you would see nuclear material reappear. Okay, and then you would have those chromosomes. Okay, and they would be in each nucleus. All right. So that is telophase one. All right, so that's the first part. So that's the first division. But remember, there are two divisions, right? So it has to go through this. Then these two cells right here are going to go through the next division. Okay, so I'm going to kind of turn it just a little bit and see if we can look over here. All right, so these two are now going to go into the next division. So this time you're going to have two cells, and this is happening simultaneously. All right, so we see the nuclear material breaking down in both of these cells. We see centrioles moving. We see spindle fibers forming. Okay, and we see, of course, the chromosomes. I'm not going to use the different colors this time just because it takes too long. Okay, so this is prophase two. Notice, it may look like it, but these chromosomes are not pairing up like they were before. Okay, so they're not synapsing together or anything. So no crossing over occurs here. All right, so that's prophase two. Then both of these cells are then going to go into metaphase two. So you got your centrioles, you got your spindle fibers, okay, and then you got the chromosomes lined up individually. They're not in pairs this time. Okay, so this is metaphase two. Then each one of these, it goes into anaphase two. All right, so we see spindle fiber shortening this time. We see the chromatids. Oh, that looks like mitosis, doesn't it? Yeah, okay, because so, this is very similar. So we see the chromatids pulling away from each other this time. And then both of these will then go into telophase. We'll see nuclear material reappearing at the end of each of these cells. And then they turn back into chromatin. Okay. And then in a guy, each one of these cells would become a sperm. Okay. So you'd end up with four functional sperm. And each one of them would have 23 chromosomes. So we'd be going from this original cell up here that had 46 chromosomes. That was the diploid number. And then you come down here to, and after both divisions, you have four cells, and each one has 23 chromosomes. So it's the haploid number. So meiosis goes from diploid to haploid. Okay. Now, that's important because if it didn't do that, we'd have the wrong number of chromosomes, okay? So remember, the reason that happens is so when the sperm, which has 23 chromosomes, and the egg, which has 23 chromosomes, come together, you have a child with 46 chromosomes, like they're supposed to have. All right, so in males, this is producing four sperm, but in females, it produces one egg, so one of these becomes the egg, and the other three become non-functional polar bodies. and they eventually just get reabsorbed by the body. Okay, so a couple of differences. Two divisions. All right, so look at it. You got prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1, telophase 1. That's the first division, okay? That has to happen before this happens, okay? So, in some of you, when you were putting your pictures in order, you were going, I think you were doing prophase 1, prophase 2, metaphase 1. Uh-uh. That doesn't make sense. You're not going to go from one cell to two cells to back to one cell, okay? So, think about it logically. You're starting out with one cell. It's going to divide into two, and then those two cells are then going to divide into two. And so you end up with four cells at the end. So you end up with four cells. They're genetically unique because of crossing over. Okay? That happens in prophase one. And they are haploid. They have half the number of chromosomes. Okay? And that's just for sex cells. So that's pollen in flowers. That's eggs in females. Sperm in males. Okay? All right. I hope that helped a little bit. If you're still confused, send me a message on Schoology. Hopefully, at some point, we'll get to where we can maybe do some real-time conferencing or something where you can ask questions and stuff. But anyway, our motivational thought for today, or our quote for today, was actually by the governor today. And the thing he said at the end, after talking about how we're going to be out of school for a while, he said, I don't know what the future holds, but I do know who holds the future. So, don't worry, guys. It's all in the Lord's hands. So we can rest in that and know that it's all going to be okay. Do your best. And I love you guys. Thinking about you, praying for you. And I miss you a lot. Okay? So do your best on all your assignments. And I'll see you soon.